Jock was back home as manager of the Scotland national side.
I think it was generally accepted it was going to be good for the game. I think everybody welcomed it.
Jock determined to lower the tone and not have so much razzmatazz around the team.
I think the fans will be realistic. I'll be realistic anyway in approach to the matches, so I won't be carrying them away of any wave of great optimism.
Build up expectations and only to fall down. He used to say, judge me at the end of qualification.
We qualified for the 1982 World Cup and then we ended up in a very difficult section. You're aware of the criticism and you're aware of the pressure building up. And looking back, I can't remember Jock passing on that pressure to us. He was a very proud man and he wouldn't like to show it to anybody that was getting to him. In the dressing room at half-time, he was obviously feeling under pressure. We were losing the game. We needed to get something from the game.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Thank you. as well, a sense of humour, and, you know, just a very impressive human being.
Well, he should be remembered as one of the greatest motivators and developers of talent that world football has produced.
Nobody who ever managed a football team brought greater talent to the job. I just don't think that in football there's ever been a greater manager than Stein.
Jock, you're immortal now.